Hi, welcome to Evention. My name is Jimmy Schramm, and today we're going to talk about...
Willow! There's my escape patient.
What'd you do to my dog?
Well, I treated her.
For what? There's nothing wrong with her.
Well, I know that, but we've been practicing our equine first aid, and I thought I'd practice on her.
Did she volunteer?
No.
All right, guys. Today we're going to talk about how to stock your equine first aid kit. Alright guys, we're here to talk about the basics first aid kit. So I have Emily with me today. She's our guest and she is my working student and groom, and we're using her first aid kit as an example. Now I've not included any injectables or prescription medications as we feel that those should be administered under veterinary supervision. So I'm going to let Emily take the reins on this as she's the one that is taking care of the horses, and let her rip.
So to start off, I always like to have Epsom salt. Most people associate it with an abscess in your horse's feet, but it's also good to soak feet with stone bruises or just any soreness. Also thrush buster, in case your horse does have thrush. You can also use it on the tops of their feet, in cracks. I also like to have saline solution. If your horse comes in from the field and has like a weeping eye, you can use it to flush out their eye. And it's also good for wounds too. Medicated powder. When I bathe the horses or wash their legs at all and they're still a little damp, I like to put this on, and it helps prevent any mud fever if they're out in a field, or rain rot as well. Wonder Dust I use in wounds that maybe need to dry more. If you've used ointment and now they're ready to scab, it's perfect. Also Blue Coat, and it's really easy. You just spray it right on. When I do use ointments, I like to use Corona, or in sensitive areas like their face, I like the aloe vera. Bag balm is good for any areas where your horse may have had irritation. If another horse bit them maybe and you want the hair to grow back, it's perfect. Or also for rubs from blankets. Petroleum jelly is also good for that.
All right, now we're on to our Evention Tip of the Day.
Okay, so now for the Evention Tip of the Day. It's always important to remember that when you have your barn medication kit, you got to have also one for the trailer. So the first thing you want to do is have a durable box like this one. Now, when you're stocking your first aid kit in the barn, don't forget to make sure that everything that was in the trailer is also stocked too. Also have it very clearly labeled so that we can find it in the case of an emergency, and make sure it's easy to get to. That's my Evention Tip for the day, and back to the medication action.
Okay, so we're back with our medical kit, and three things that I like to use when cleaning wounds are betadine, rubbing alcohol, or hydrogen peroxide, so any of those would be good to have in your kit. When I'm cleaning wounds, I like to always wear rubber gloves. It just keeps the wounds clean and you don't get any germs that are on your hands in the wound. Tape is really important. Here I have two kinds, duct tape and also medical tape, so either of those is fine too. Another really important thing to always have is vet wrap. I also like Elasticon. It's really super adhesive. And next to that is gauze wrap, which you can use underneath of the vet wrap to help keep the skin less irritated. And at the very end, we have two different kinds of gauze pads, square pads and round pads. Either are good, but you can use these to clean wounds or to protect them underneath of a wrap, but you just want to always make sure that they're sterile so that they're in the packaging before you use them so that you don't get any other germs in the wound. Also, scissors are important to have. Here we have basic scissors, but also bandage scissors are good too. Having a hoof pick is just good in any kit you have, so to have one of those is good, and a thermometer. You can use a digital thermometer or a basic thermometer like I have here, and you can just get that at your basic CVS or pharmacy. And that wraps up our medical kit. So thanks for watching and stay tuned next week. All right, before he treats the whole barn. See you guys later.
Are you excited to be stuck inside for another bitterly cold winter, barely being able to ride your horse, snow and terrible temperatures? I thought you weren't, so I got some exciting news for you. Dram Equestrian will be based in Aiken, South Carolina for the winter, and we are currently looking to take horses in for training, competition, and also horses to be sold. So take advantage of our really competitive rates, check us out, and we'll look forward to seeing you and your horse in Aiken.
Face?
Yeah, I'm mumbling.
Just the mouth.
Emily. Your turn. I don't know if I can do it. Didn't you ever canter as a kid?
Like a horse. Yes. He's in the middle. That's why he's doing it, because he's in that arena and in the barn aisle. don't just... How do you even do that? You're like Lord of the Dance.